Good morning everyone. Hey, this is Vaishali Siddhappa again. Welcome to my channel. So today's class I'm going to talk about, briefly explain the theory which is one of the famous theory for in economics, the law of diminishing marginal utility. The law of diminishing marginal utility. So what is the law of diminishing marginal utility? So this law of diminishing marginal utility is one of the example theory for cardinal approach. So when I'm going to continue, I'll tell you what exactly it is. It's one of the examples for cardinal approach, and let me tell you, this theory is introduced by Gosson. He is one of the German economists, so that's why we call it this theory as a Gosson's law. And after that, finally, this theory is popularized by Alfred Marshall. So he is the one who briefed it very nicely. He gave basics as he took it this topic as a very basic, and he developed so many other theories. So before talking about this, let me go with assumptions. Just imagine now, if you want to understand this particular topic, you have to see my previous video. The previous video, it is about the last topic which I have discussed. It is exactly about this. I have explained why you are going to get minus 2, minus 1. These all topics I have already discussed. So you better to, see that topic, so then you will understand better. So now we'll talk about assumptions. Before developing any theory, you need maximum of assumptions. So every theory will be having some of assumptions. Let's see. The first one is, I'm talking about consuming any particular good. Which good we are talking about now? The first one is standard unit. If I'm consuming any of the good, so here we have taken an example of good. So right now everything is going here. So just keep with assumption. Just keep listening. Whatever goods and services you're going to eat, whatever good you're going to eat, whatever fruit, vegetable you're going to eat, whichever food you're going to consume, standard, the size should be very much standard. The standard means it should be like, it's not be extremes. It should not be very big like a watermelon. It should not be very small like a grape. It should be medium size like apple, orange, what we are seeing in a one average size. So that's called as a standard size. One cup of a coffee is a standard size. One sip of a coffee, one spoon of a coffee, it is not standard. It is very extreme. Never, it is very less. So whatever we are going to take as example, it should be standard in a size. And the next one, you have to consider, it should be identical in taste, in smell, in the size. Each and everything should be same. So that means only one particular sweet if I am consuming, each and every sweet which I am consuming after that, it should be the same one. That means homogeneous. This point talks about homogeneous, exactly same. If I am eating the first apple, that means second fruit which I am eating, third fruit which I am going to eat, it should be apple only. And the third one says no interval. What it means, no interval? No interval means while consuming any of the fruit. I have taken an example here, apple. Just taken an example as apple. If I am eating apple, I am not going to give any breaks for it. No break, no intervals. I am not going to give any kind of a intervals. Why I am not going to give any interval? For example, morning I am going to have one apple. Afternoon I am going to have one apple. And third, at the night I am going to have an apple. It's not going to, I cannot prove this theory with the help of that. So, if you want to prove this theory, you should not give any kind of a breaks. It should be continuous process. I just finished one apple, second one I am going with, third one I am going with, fourth one I am going with, sixth one I am going with. Continuously, without giving any intervals and break, I am going to consume that product. Next one says, consumer is a rational consumer. Who is a rational consumer? Every consumer here rational, because they always try to think, being a consumer, to get maximum satisfaction. So consumer is a rational, I told you yesterday also. So we always thinks, expects maximum satisfaction. So consumer is rational means we are always expecting, each and every consumer here, we are expecting the maximum satisfaction. After having one apple, I am not going to stop. One apple is not going to satisfy me. Till the time I feel like it is enough in whole life, I am not going to eat. Till that point, I will be eating and eating and eating. So, consumer is a rational one. And one more here, constant prices. The prices, what we are going to talk here, the prices are very much constant. We are not going to change this particular apple price. If prices varies, automatically demand and the consumption is going to change. So that's why we're going to stick to constant prices. We're going to say that the price actually it is not going to change at all. Continuously till the time you're going to reach 6th unit. So if you want to have the 7th unit also, till that time the price will be constant. It is not going to change. The last one here, ordinary person. This theory is not applicable to the ordinary person. Why it is not applicable to the ordinary person? See, it is extraordinary person. Extraordinary person means I'm a normal person, I'm an ordinary person. For me, eating 2 apple, 3 apple without any food, without consuming any food, if I'm consuming 2 to 3 apple, it is more than enough. Maximum people eats 1 or 2 also. Just imagine the maximum core. If I'm eating 4 apples, that also, I'm an ordinary person. Maximum people are there, so few people are there, for an example, who's not going to stop at 3 or 4, they're going to eat 20, 30, 40 pieces of apple. Then they will be called as extraordinary people. But in casual way, this is not the possible thing. But for the sake of assumption, for this people, the people who are extraordinary, who can eat 20, 30 apples at a time, for them this theory is not applicable. So right now, the size should be standard, not extreme level. Taste, flavor, so taste, smell, size, everything should be same. No break between consuming, everybody thinking, expecting maximum satisfaction. The good till the time I'm consuming, till the time I'm going to get, it's a constant prices. It is, this theory is not applicable for extraordinary people. So now, let me come with this table. For this table explanation, you have to see my previous class. When I started the second chapter exactly, I explained you ordinal approach and the cardinal approach. Now I have to explain here cardinal approach. What is the meaning of cardinal approach? This dot diminishing marginal utility is the one of the theory of cardinal approach. What it says? It says you can measure utility in terms of number. That is also one of the assumption. You can measure utility in terms of numbers 1, 2, 3, 35, 45. So this way, you can measure your utility in terms of number. So that methodology is called cardinal approach. We have one more approach to measure utility, that is ordinal approach. I'll be coming with that in the next classes. So cardinal approach, as I said, we can measure utility in terms of number. To measure cardinal utility, we have to understand what is total utility and marginal utility. In yesterday's class, I already have briefed about what is total utility and marginal utility. And continuously I'm consuming first, second class, third class, fourth class, and the fifth class, and the sixth class, how exactly both are going to behave. We have analyzed this in the yesterday's class. So without that particular talk dragging again, explaining that, I'll quit to explain this particular table. But this table is really important. If you want to know what exactly it is, you have to see the previous classes of mind consumer behavior, the first topic. So now, you got to know here, the 6 units are there. This is total utility and marginal utility. Total utility and continuously till here it is increasing, till here. After this particular ratio become constant, and this point it started diminishing. It decreasing, yeah, diminishing. You can see the arrow mark, first increasing, 24, it is constant, and here it started decreasing. On the other side, you have marginal utility, which is continuously decreasing. You can see it was 12, it's 6, it's 4, it's 2, it's 0, it's minus 2. That means whenever you're going to consume each one individual unit, how much satisfaction you are going to get, that will be explained through marginal greedy. When you are using consuming sixth unit of apple, the satisfaction what you are going to get, it is only minus 2. Minus means it is already negative. You are not getting any satisfaction, but at the same time you are feeling like in whole life you are not going to eat this. So in this one it's already zero. When you consume the fifth one, it is zero. You have not got any, not even single percent of satisfaction. When you consume the fourth, at least you have got 2 units of satisfaction. But let me tell you, when you're going to consume the first unit, you're going to get maximum satisfaction. So that's called initial utility. For these concepts, as I said, total utility, marginal utility and initial utility, you have to see my previous class. So now, let me tell you this now. So with the help of this table, I have constructed the diagram now. In the x-axis, we have quantity of a commodity, which is quantity is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you can see in the x-axis. In the y-axis, I have the total utility and the marginal utility. So you can say TU plus MU. So we have both here. So let me tell you how I started drawing this. Maximum number is 24 in a TU. Anyways, MU is less only. So maximum number I saw 24, so I started with the 30. So 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. So in the x-axis we have exact units which I went with. So let me tell you how I constructed. So when you have one unit, TU is 12, then 18, 22, 24. It's a 24 again, it's a constant without changing. Then it started, 22, it came down. MU, it is 12 only, so we started with the same point. We are starting MU also at the same point. 6, 4, it is 2, and it is 0. Fifth unit, but it is 0. It's a minus 2, so we constructed minus here. So finally, it came here, minus 2. By joining freehand curve, so we got the TU curve and we have got the MU curve. You can see how MU curve is behaving and the TU curve is behaving. We analyze this now. So first time you can see TU curve is continuously increasing. Isn't it? It is increasing in diminishing way. Let me tell you, keep it in this way. TU is increasing in diminishing way. That means whenever he is adding extra unit, the satisfaction is diminishing. So TU is increasing in diminishing way. Extra utility is decreasing. So we'll say that TU is increasing. 12, 18, 22, 24. So TU is increasing, but from the individual what you're getting, it is less. So TU is increasing in the diminishing way. In the beginning, you can say that from here to here, here to here, here to here, continuously it is increasing. This point, can you see here? So after this point, what exactly happened is, TU started after consuming the fifth unit. After consuming the fifth unit too, the TU remained the same. It is not changing. It remained the same here. So we got the straight line. If it's increasing, it will be the curve. Decreasing, this is the curve. Constant, this and this will be the curve. So this way you can see this constant line here. This both are constant. Here also you got the 24 units. Here also you got the 24 units. After getting the 24 units, when you're consuming the 6th unit, 22, you can see this, TU started diminishing. Clear? So, when you're going to talk about marginal utility, it is 12, started decreasing to 6, 4, 2 and 5 and negative. So, you can see that marginal utility continuously decreasing. It is decreasing, but it in the beginning increasing, constant and this. Now, let me tell you what exactly the theory is. We are talking about so much, finally we have to talk about this. See, any person who is an ordinary person, he is a rational consumer. He thinks for maximum satisfaction. He is going to consume one of the fruit to get maximum satisfaction. How are you going to measure? I'll tell you now. So he comes, just imagine, I started eating apple. I had one. I got the maximum satisfaction. Let me tell you, whenever you're going to eat anything, You're very thirsty, you're coming back home, you're drinking water, the first sip, the first glass, the first spoon, the first bite, your first fruit always gives you the maximum satisfaction. That is what we are trying to say here. When you consume the first one, you got the highest satisfaction, the maximum satisfaction, which is called as initial satisfaction or initial utility. So after getting initial utility, you did not starve yourself because you cannot give any interval to prove this theory. You did not starve yourself after getting the maximum satisfaction. You just continued self. You continued with the first one, second one, and the third one, and the fourth one. So the time you started consuming one after one, apple, your satisfaction started diminishing, isn't it? First you got wow, you really felt like it's a best moment. I'm really tasting yummy thing. I'm really feeling very good. After when you continued, automatically you got to know that your satisfaction started decreasing. One after one, same good. If you're changing the particular fruit or something, most probably again your satisfaction will increase. But I'm telling you to continuously having the same fruit, so definitely your satisfaction level will start decreasing. When your satisfaction level, it's going to decrease. You can see this marginal utility which is added to the total. It will start diminishing. So this is the diminishing. So that's the reason why marginal utility is going to diminish. Continuously when going to have, continuously one after one, one point of time you feel like why I have purchased this apple and why I am consuming. So sometime most probably you feel like in whole life I'm not going to have this. This definitely point comes sometime you are craving for something to have outside. You'll go outside, you're too much craving for that. You'll order in too much, you're going to order in a plenty. When you have ordered, you're eating it, finally you're offering your friends, your family members, they're saying that we are done, we cannot eat. You're eating, you're ordered yourself and you want to eat more, but you have reached that point, you feel like even though that's your favorite, without giving a break, you eat it so much, finally you feel like, oh my god, this is the last time I'm going to eat. After this point, I'm not going to have it. So that point is called, the point you feel like, this is the, I'm done, this is much, so after this I'm not going to have it. That point is called saturation point. That means that's the point you feel like I'm done, I cannot have it more, my satisfaction is dead. So that time, that point is called saturation point. Let me explain you now. The first unit when you're consuming, both are 12 units. The both are 12 units. So that's called initial utility, which is maximum. You can see from the first unit what you got is 12 units. When you consume the second one, third one and the fourth one, which is second, third and the fourth, it is increasing only. It is, but MU will start decreasing. Can you see MU is continuously decreasing? It's a maximum. It becomes 6, 4 and 2 finally. But when you are consuming the fifth unit, you will reach the maximum any time, any number which is repeated. Then the repeated number is a maximum satisfaction. Don't consider this as a maximum because you don't know whether it will become 26 or 25, you are not aware of. So you have to wait for the repetition. The same number is repeated, then the next number will be considered as the maximum. Both are 24, we have to consider this as a maximum. But when you're reaching maximum, at the same time, MU should reach the zero. You can see here, we reached maximum, which is 24. At the same time, marginal utility reached zero, which is here, this point. This point is called saturation point. This point is called saturation point. Can you see here? This point is called saturation point. When you're going to have the sixth unit, you can see that even Q will start diminishing. But it is not reaching negative. In any of the theory, any of the book written by so many other people, if you're going to see the law of diminishing marginal utility, we can see that it is decreasing. But till now, it's my personal experience, I have never seen it reach negative. negative. So TU will diminish but will not reach negative. But marginal utility at any cost, it will reach the negative. So TU started diminishing after reaching the maximum. It started diminishing. You can see this. The curve, it is coming downward. So this, after this, the sixth, when you are going to consume, it will reach negative. Can you see the sixth unit, TU will decrease, get diminished, but MU will reach its negative. MU is going to reach its negative number. And the last one says when TU reaches its maximum, which is this point, and MU will be zero. That point is called saturation point. Yeah? So this is the theory. Now, is it happens with everything? So whenever anybody is going to construct, anybody is going to introduce any kind of a theory, so definitely you will be having some limitations. What are the limitations you will be having? The limitations is, this theory is not applicable for the skew of the things. For an example, rare collections. You are collecting stamps and these all stuff. Few people are collecting coins, stamps. More you collect, you feel more satisfied. So this theory is not applicable. This theory says more you consume the same good, your satisfaction is going to decrease. For the rare collection, this is not going to happen. It can be antique pieces, it can be stamps, it can be coins. It is not going to deteriorate. What about money? Why people are so corrupted in this country or anywhere? Because they are craving so much money, for money. So the time they will be earning and earning, they are getting more money. They are not satisfied. Their satisfaction is not coming down the way marginal utility is coming down mine for the apple. It is not going to come. The more money I get it, so definitely my satisfaction is going to increase. It will not diminish. So knowledge, more knowledge I will be getting. So acquiring, so definitely I feel good. I never feel it's a deteriorating, it is decreasing. What about art? So definitely you feel better. Innovations, precious goods, fashion and beauty. More you get, more you'll get utility, more you'll get satisfaction. So in these all cases and other few examples, you cannot come with a conclusion that more you're going to get, the satisfaction is going to deteriorate. It is possible in only few of the cases. On the other side, you have importance. These are the limitations what I have said. And let's come with the importance. Why this theory is so important in economics? Let me tell you, we have in India, we have a tax which is called as a progressive tax. What is progressive tax? The way income increases, tax ratio also is going to increase. We have different slabs in our country. Lesser income will be paying lesser taxes. Higher income people, they will be paying higher taxes. Why this is happening? Because the higher people, the people who are rich enough, they are getting more income. The government is going to take more taxes from them, and they're going to collect it and they're going to use it for the public welfare. Finally, that money will be reaching to the poor. So to bring economy equal distribution of wealth and money, this progressive tax is really going to work in a very positive way. So that's why definitely for the progressive tax, this theory is important. The time you will reach the satisfaction, so after that the taxation rate is also going to increase. So next one, because of this theory, so many other theories are developed. We're going to talk about that in the future. Law of demand, elasticity of demand, consumer surplus, determining prices. So right now I'm going to talk about much about it, but basically you just understand these all theories are developed because of this theory. When I'm going to talk about these theory, definitely I'm going to tell you how this theory is connected to those topics. So next, to equal distribution, I just told you, progressive tax is one of the important tax what we have in our country, which makes, they know that after reaching earning this much, the person have reached already saturation point after earning. After that, taxation should be increased. So by keeping in that point, after getting earning so much, he will be saturated. So his satisfaction will be very much, very higher. If his satisfaction is very higher, he should pay more money. So by keeping that money, so that concept, they have introduced progressive tax. The last one, so to use resources economically. If you are a consumer, where you want to stop yourself? Do you want to stop yourself here? Do you want to stop yourself here? Otherwise, do you want to complete your satisfaction by consuming the sixth unit? If I am a consumer, definitely I'll stop my, consumption in the fifth point, in the fifth unit. Because already appeared 4. Here in US 5th unit, after consuming, I'm getting 0. Why should I have to consume then? Where, if you are a brainy, where you have to stop yourself consuming? When you're going to consume the 4th unit, so you're going to get to know that the maximum satisfaction you already have reached, and at least marginal utility is 2 units. That means you're going to get some amount of satisfaction. So being a consumer, so you have to stop at that point where at least you're getting some point of satisfaction. Otherwise, no need of purchasing, no need of wasting your hard-earned money. For that reason, these two goods, what you're purchasing, it is economically based because you're not going to get any kind of a satisfaction. It's better that stopping and using these resources economically, so when you're satisfied yourself with the only 4th unit, you have to stop your consumption. This way, it talks about even how you're going to use your resources economically. So this is it now for today. So in the next class, I'm going to meet with the ordinal approach. Thank you so much.